Well, hello there, everybody. Dre here, and welcome back to the game where we bang lots of balls together. We're playing some more Marble World. You guys seem to really enjoy the first episode, so I thought we'd try and do one more course now that I'm a little bit better at the whole Marble Run game. So what I immediately wanted to do here is design like a Plinko board for the start and hopefully have some go to longer tracks and then some go to very short tracks, obviously, if they can get in the middle of the Plinko board. I haven't built it yet. I wanted to implement some of the actual surroundings as well because I didn't really do that in the first episode. So yeah, we have this here. So now we can spawn all our marbles and get them to go down this way. I just realized I don't think I'm going to use this one because the buttons are on the other side. And yeah, I can't even see them through the wall if I did want to use them. So we'll just delete that. Okay, so we're gonna get them all to meet here. This is on a little bit of an incline, as you can see right there. That way they don't obviously get stuck there. We're gonna have a nice big Plinko board. All right, so I don't want them all going on the Plinko board at the same time. So we're gonna have this thing going up. That's going to give them a little bit of momentum as well. And now I gotta figure out if I can even do a Plinko board. There should be a nice, yes, there's a nice, well, that's not that big. Is this, how big is this one? Oh, that's the one I was using. There's nothing bigger. I just need a big flat piece of plywood. All right, this should be a good start. So we're gonna angle this, not backwards, forwards, just a little bit, obviously. Okay, and let's test it. So we're going to spawn just manually all these. The great thing is this is going to spread and go all the way up this. This is exactly what I wanted. Uh-oh. Why you do this? All right, so I angled it just a little bit. Please work. I spent a long time on this already. I don't get it. They're still doing it. Why? Oh, I see the reason. I need to drop this whole thing down a little bit because the block that picks them up is angled slightly when it's hitting this bottom floor. So if we drop this down just like an inch or two, it should hopefully... There we go. We hit it. I just gotta make sure everything's aligned. It's good. That's what I wanted to see. Oh my god. I was a little worried there that this whole plan wasn't going to work. All right, testing it out with 720. It looks like it is stable. Did one just fall? How did that do that? One just went backwards on this and fell down. You can actually see it moving right there. That's impressive. So I did want the majority to go to the middle. I was hoping they'd spread to the sides a little bit more, but that's okay. The important part is this is working fantastically. Now it's going to have a nice slow amount of them coming to the Plinko board because I didn't want them all going at the same time. So this is really fast. That would not be fun. Whoa, we got new physics items. Bounce pads, baby. Okay, I didn't even know they updated this. We'll have to definitely use those later. I was hoping they would add glass. Because obviously, if we put this directly downwards, the balls will just fall off this. So I'm going to have to angle it slightly. Just because I can't put glass in front of it to force these things to stay on the board. So I think that angle should be good. I don't think many will bounce off. Some might. But again, as long as the majority make it, that's the important part. All right, first test. And ooh, they're still getting a little too much speed. I mean, this obviously is working. I don't want them bouncing on the board though. So I need to slow them down. So what I think we'll do here is this is on a little bit of an angle. So if we flatten that, that works a hell of a lot better. Still getting a decent amount of speed. I think some will definitely fall off. I don't know if there's a way where I could possibly keep them all on here for sure, unless I angle this even more. I guess I could do that. It's not the perfect Plinko board. Obviously, you want it directly downwards. But I also don't want to lose all my marbles before this even starts. Oh, unfortunately, because these are not tracks, there's this little hump here. I cannot get rid of it. Thing is, I designed it so the top piece would be higher than the lower piece, so I didn't think they would bounce, but unfortunately, they are. Damn it. All right, so let's see what this... What? Oh, there's a little bit of a lip there. Okay, my bad. Let's just drop this a bit. There we go. Still bouncy. That's way better, though. I think that's as good as I'm gonna get it without spending an hour on this. And this video is already 45 minutes long. All right, let's add some pizzazz here. I think I'm pretty happy with this layout. I haven't tested it yet, obviously, so it might be absolutely awful. But I added some physics-based items and then obviously the generic Plinko stuff. So we got some triangles as well as some of these nails to hopefully get most of the people out of the middle. The ultimate goal is to get most of the sides and then make the middle a shortcut. The big question is, will it actually work though? And oh, most are actually staying on. I mean, some will fall off. I could put bigger walls on, But I mean, honestly, this looks really good. There's a nice spread at the bottom. Most don't seem to be going down the middle, but there's a high amount of them going down the middle. So I don't want to make the shortcut too big for the middle, but I definitely want to give them the benefit. Okay, there we go. I actually really like this design. So we got 6 tubes coming out. I don't think, they might get stuck there, actually. I might need to pull that back a little bit. Let's do that right now. I just want to make sure none fall out the back of these, obviously. So that should be, yeah, that's more than good enough. And then we don't run the risk of them getting stuck on that little lip that was there. But yeah, that should be good. This will give us a bunch of different routes to go on. And I'm so excited. This is actually kind of working. Let's paint these two just because the colors are fun. So unfortunately, these marble collectors are a bit too big for these tubes. So we might get some, I don't know. It's hard to tell. Will any get stuck over there? Probably a little bit. At this point, I'm sure you guys know, I don't really care if some get stuck. I just want to build cool courses, damn it. And I think this is going to be damn interesting. And it also gives the benefit of the first marbles making in here getting a head start. So testing it out. Oh yeah, this looks good. I just want to see how many actually get stuck in. Some are flying over, as you can see. I could put a wall up there if I want to, but then it ruins the look of it. And I really like the look of this thing. So I just want to make sure. Okay, yeah, we got, as you can see, one. Okay, that's nothing to worry about. There's like a few in there. And then obviously we even have jams in these things. I can't do anything about that. They should unjam themselves if there's enough weight behind them, but some are just going to have to die there. All right, I don't want to spoil everything, but this took like 2 hours, so I'll show you more of it later. I will say it is working fantastically. So yeah, that's our first major obstacle done. We're going to move on, and I'd like to do something possibly with these bouncies. I don't know if we'll do that next, but by the end of this, we definitely will. All right, so right now the ultimate goal is I have to get back up to the top. So what we're going to do is, I think, do another game of luck here, and that is we'll put these things. I never actually used these yet, but we'll have this cheese board top going down to different layers, I think. Obviously, the top layer is going to be the fastest. We'll add some blockades as it goes deeper and deeper down. So the ultimate goal is to stay at the top, because the further you go down, the slower you're going to be. So yeah, we'll do that, and then we'll add this again. And what I'm going to do, just to keep the same incline, because it's very hard to keep inclines in this game, is we'll control V this and then put this directly underneath. All right, so we'll do something like that. That should actually be really great. And then obviously I'll add a few small traps here. I think we'll just use the nails as per usual. I don't want to add too many because these nails do make things get stuck on them sometimes. And I think the majority are definitely going to fall down at least this first layer. And then the second layer, we'll add a hell of a lot more nails. We essentially want this to be a death pit. If they get stuck in here, they deserved it. All right, a surprising amount stay on the top. So this is fantastic. This is exactly what I wanted. And then these ones obviously are getting slower and slower, being banged by nails. I'm having so much fun building this one. This is a little off center, but I don't care. It's good enough. All right, so after the cheese grater of doom, we have this little jump pad here. I'm gonna see if any of the top ones can get extremely lucky and maybe get a head start going up to the top. I doubt it will work, but it'd be amazing if it actually can. I'm just adding these walls here because in my testing, these pads make them go a little bit sideways, obviously, and I don't want them falling off for being first. The point is to give them a reward, not, you know, throw them off the damn track. But I gotta say, we're keeping a lot of marbles on the track. Let's actually check after 1,080 went through. Obviously, we have a couple on the nail. I don't want to spoil too much here, but trust me, there's no blockades behind me. The big question is there many in here? We still have this issue. I don't know how to fix this. Every now and then it just happens. But with how many marbles we're using, it's not a huge deal, just kind of frustrating. The big thing is we don't have any buildups up here, which is great. Everything is working fantastic. Actually, oh my God, seriously? All right, well, I don't care about those ones. We'll fix this up a little bit too before the end of this, but this is going extremely well. Looks like one of the tubes just got unblocked, actually. Let's see if any are lucky enough to get down here. And, oh, unfortunately, I might need to add an extra wall. There we go. That blue one almost got on. If we can see any get on once this is full, that would be fantastic. All right, I don't know if this is going to work, but can you tell what my goal is for this run? Can you tell by what you're looking at? All right, my test subjects. Let's see that trajectory. And And okay, actually, they all go, because it's curved and they're all sticking to the side, they all go pretty much the same area, pretty close to that gamepad. Well, we seem to have a little bit of a problem. This is a common occurrence. I usually edit it out, but I leaned it a little bit far to the back and not enough this way, I guess. Oh my god. Oh! Oh, did you see that? I'm only gonna need one. Holy Jesus, one actually bounced inside of it. So, obviously, the goal of this stupid run is to make it inside the donut. Last episode, we spawned 500 and something, and only two made it in my hole. That sounded wrong. Can we do even worse? Can one make it in this? That's the big question. And honestly, I'm really happy with this, so let's put it to the test. If there's any major issues, we can make changes, but yeah, I think this should be pretty good. So we'll delete the marbles. I don't know how many I want to spawn, but I guess I should show you the whole thing in all of its glory. So to do that, let's do a test run here. I'm just fixing this a little bit because things like to get stuck there. And we'll just spawn. This is not the official run, so if any get in, it doesn't count, damn it. But we're just gonna spawn a little bit just so you can see it from the start. All right, so they make it to the Plinko board. I gotta say, probably my favorite part of this whole design, going into the tubes. This took me the longest to do because I had to angle each of these manually, and it is a nightmare. I angled these boards slightly so they go to the middle as well, reaching down to here. And obviously, as you can see, the goal is to get to the middle because that's much faster than the outside runs. Going down here, they make it over here. I don't know, that green one made it, didn't it? There's no way it's that much higher. So these things actually work. Oh, that's fantastic. That's what I was hoping for. One, to get that distinct advantage to get way ahead of the rest. Now, that being said, it all comes down to a little bit of luck at the end, but at least he gets the first try of getting lucky at the top. All right, and there he goes at the top. Let's see, is he actually gonna hit this thing? Come on, there you go. It goes so high. Oh, he almost got it. Okay, they're all over the place, but I did not calculate that at all. And the fact that they're getting, oh, damn it. We already got one in. Blue is not the winner this time. This was a test. I think we're gonna have a lot more winning this. There's a bigger hole to get him in. It's gonna be hard to keep up. We already got four with only 180 on there. I kind of like that more made it though. And yeah, just checking the track out, it doesn't look like there's any major buildups here. I could have fixed small issues if you guys do enjoy this. I would actually like to maybe build upon this course in future episodes if this is something that you guys enjoy. So let me know in the comments below. The big question is, are these things still building up? For the record, these things always deplete. They just take a long time. Sometimes like 10 minutes for them to actually start moving again. So yeah, it looks like compared to my last marble run, this one's much more stable. I think I will definitely fix this a little bit. We just got to add a few more of these things here. Okay, there we go. Something with a small incline like that should be much better. We might get a few, but that's okay. All right, let's try it. I think I'm going to go. God, it's gonna be so... I'm so actually kind of bummed how good this course is. Because I was hoping it'd be harder than the other one, but that bounce trajectory is perfect. I think we're gonna go for, like, close to 2,000. So we'll slowly spawn these in. Put your guesses in the comments below. What color's gonna win? I gotta go for my homeboy watermelon once again. But yeah, we'll see what happens here. I think that's enough. 1,800. I don't want to miss any of this stuff. I mean, we already got ones coming down. Let's slow it down a little bit. Middle, already at the end, just as I wanted. These guys should get the upper hand, and watermelon is currently in second. Actually, did it fall off the course? This is a little bit of a danger area here. Some get out a little early, but most may make it onto the course. Going down into the turnabout, having a few fall off, but not much. We just had one fall off there, as you can see, so I gotta work on that board a little bit. Actually, they're falling off the side over there, so if I add more over there, we're fine. I gotta stop looking at my course, though. Who cares about the course? The big moment is, who is going to win this? Is anybody gonna make it on the bounce pad and get upper hand? Not purple. Purple is way ahead of the pack, though. Do we got any down below? Yeah, we got some poor, unfortunate souls down below. Red almost making it up. We almost missed that. Come on, purple. You can do it. Get the upper hand. So you got to get lucky and get right inside there. And the more marbles that are on the lift, the less chance they have of bouncing in. Oh, red, you just almost had it. This is probably my favorite part. I don't know why. It's just they actually do get a big head start. There we go. We got yellow. Pushing into second place with that bounce. I finally saw one on recording, and I'm so happy that that works. All right, I just saw blue go in. White just went over. Rest in peace, white. So a lot of them are still making it. A lot harder now that these things are filled, though. How are we doing in the back as we wait for these things to go? Yeah, we definitely got to work on this. They're falling off a lot over here. Obviously, the Plinko board's a little dangerous. What I wanted to make sure is any ones that are up here don't get an upper hand. That's why I didn't design any of the course over here, because a lot do fall off. So I want to make sure that none are taking drastic shortcuts. But yeah, you can see the delay here. Is what I really wanted. I wanted to have marbles all about the course, and this is a good buildup in my opinion. We have a lot at the bottom, obviously, but we still have some going down the Plinko board at the top. How are we doing over here? Do we have any buildups? No, we're basically done. Wow, how did you guys get in there? I guess 2,000 is a bit much, but God, this thing just looks so good. I'm so happy with my build here. And yeah, all things considered, we obviously have a lot that have fallen off, but if I just add a few more boards to the sides here, because I didn't add much, I think the majority of our fall-offs will be depleted. And maybe I should make this top a bit harder. The goal was to get only like maybe 10% going on the top. It's looking like about half. Maybe a little less than half. I can actually make it all the way amazingly. All right, we're getting a little bit of a buildup here. 2,000 might be a little too much for this course. I'm worried that they're actually going to have a traffic jam here. We'll find out. We should be nearing the top now. Man, this is a long ways up. I like this delay, though. It gives me a chance to watch some of the guys in the back try to catch up. Okay, we have our first ones coming over. Pink is ahead. And is it going to make it? Bouncing on the pad. Come on, first one would be amazing. Way overshot. Nothing in the donut yet. I do have to pay attention to the donut to see who actually wins, because we're gonna have a lot of things bouncing. They go past the roof. I just realized that they bounce off the roof, and the ones that actually hit the roof are the ones that might fall in the donut. Oh, that was a close tie. We have purple as the winner. Pink is second. There's going to be so many in here. I'm just going to go to three. I want to watch the rest of the course. So yeah, if your money was on marble 31 or 492, you guys made a good guess. Or purple and pink. Man, are we going to get a third? I hope we don't get a third. That'd be amazing. We still have a lot to do. And there it goes. Clearly, it likes purple and pink, because we got the purple and pink. Galaxy Marble is the third. Wasn't it last time that they were all blue? It's kind of weird. This is so fun to watch. We'll see how many actually go in there by the end. We have a lot to go through here. All right, loads are still making their way. I don't know how many have went in the donut, but so many are so accurate to that. How are we doing over here? Oh, actually, I was worried about this part, but I put it on a good incline, it looks like. Might just need to put a little wedge here to perfect this course later on. It's looking like they're all going to get through. Anything down here? No buildups. We still probably will have some in the tubes. These are the ones that take a while. Yeah, you can see they kind of just hold on to them for a while. Hopefully they'll be let go soon, because I can't really do much about this. The tubes are not in the way. So yeah, it's looking like some are being let go right now. You just got to be patient with them. Still getting this damn thing catching some over here. I'll have to fix that too. And the final of the first major wave are coming up. We got some in behind a little bit, as you can see. They're going to slowly unload as they unstick on the pipes. But that is the majority of them done. What are we working with in the marble? I just saw another one go in. I made this too easy, damn it. Look at how many made it. It's kind of creepy how many pink and purple are in here, though. We have 9 that are not purple and pink, and it looks like 6 or 7 that are. Kind of weird considering how many color combinations there are. And finally, it's looking like it's getting unstuck. So I think that's all of them now. Oh, I'm so happy they finally did. It's like 10 minutes later, but gravity helps after a while. Is it already empty? No, it's still got a ways to go. But as you can see, it's flowing well now. Come on, little guys. There's something pleasing about watching the last few marbles just make their way out. And there they go. Oh, I'm so happy that unclogged. It was gonna bother me if we did have a little bit of cloggage. All right, and here comes the final few. Is there gonna be any other lucky ones that make it in the hole? Come on, one at the end would be fantastic. It doesn't look good. I think that's all of them. Damn it. I mean, let's not complain, though, when your hole is filled. No, I'm not going to say that. But yes, my donut is filled with marbles. Let's just go that way. And yeah, on that, guys, I need a break. This was an all-day endeavor. Don't get me wrong. It was really fun to make, but I'm starting to lose my marbles, literally. So yeah, if you guys want to see more of this, hit that like button. I'd like to actually maybe build upon this course. That, or maybe I'll just do a whole new course. I don't know. What do you guys think? I got to say, I really like the start of this. The end could be a little bit better. Maybe we could build another major contraption like this to add to this. But yeah, I had a blast playing it. I hope you guys enjoyed watching it. And as always, thanks for watching and liking, guys. I'll see you in the next one.